Hey guys, welcome back to Kevin Wilson SBC. I have a really cool video to share with you today around big tire slicks with four link rear suspension. And all we're going to do is change the upper bar angle one hole at a time. This video footage is complimentary and provided to me by Z of ZHTunes. Z purchased the 69 Barracuda from Tony that I helped with last August on the Woodward Avenue Roadkill Nights Big Tire Hellcat 6-speed event. The car now has a turbo 400 in it, and Z has been working with the 4-link to get the car launched down the track. And really big shout out to Z. He said that if any customers came to him for Hellcat tuning or any consultation around their Hellcat platforms, and if you mentioned Kevin Wilson SBC, he would make sure that you got priority service. Z is a really sharp guy. I really enjoy speaking with him. I enjoy his content, and I encourage you to check out his contact information in the description of this video. Some information to set up what we're getting ready to go through. The bottom bar on this car is pretty much parallel to the ground. No uphill, no downhill angle, parallel to the ground. And I'm going to show you the 4-link plot of all three runs and what the change did. So this is going to be really cool. Remember, the only change from video to video is the upper bar angle. And we're going to start with the upper bar, the second hole from the bottom on the top, and then we're going to move up to the third hole, then we're going to move up to the fourth hole, and you're going to get to see exactly how the car reacts with a big tire slick car, turbo 400, and a decent stall speed on the launch. Let's jump into this video. This is going to be really cool. So here's what we're going to do. I want to show you the suspension setup for the first video, and this is what we have on the screen now. You can see that the car has a 38.9, let's call that 39-inch instant center length. The instant center height is 9 inches off the ground, and the anti-squat value is 113.5%. And there's a lot of good information on this screen right here. Now, this is pretty close to the anti-squat line. Remember my video a couple weeks ago where I talked about the anti-squat line is a reference point. It's not a hard, fast rule. Your drag car does not know if the instant center is on the anti-squat line, below or above it. And to be frank with you, the position of the instant center in relation to the center of gravity really dictates more how the chassis is going to react. And if you look at this, the instant center is pretty far behind the center of gravity. Even though we're only at 113% anti-squat, let's take a look and see how this car responds with this current 4-link setup. So we're going to go ahead and do that now. With the top bar in the second hole from the bottom on the top, and let's see how this looks. All right, let's watch that again. Notice how hard it throws the wheel to the track. It really hits the big tire sidewall really hard, and the car pretty much bunny hops and leaves the track and unloads and goes nowhere. So that's the top bar in the second hole from the bottom on the top. Now let's look at the instant center for run number two. Here we have a 48-inch instant center, but notice we're still behind the center of gravity. That's an important thing to pick up when you're talking about a big tire slick car, especially. This car for these videos only has single adjustable strange engineering coilover shocks. And I have video after video on shock valving and dyno tuning of shocks. And I can just tell you right now, a single adjustable strange engineering coilover shock has very little rebound valving to control a big tire slick car with anything around the neutral line, especially with more than 100% anti-squat. And you can see we're now at 92.1%. We are under 100% anti-squat. So if the math is correct, the car should squat. But remember, the anti-squat line, that neutral line, is a reference only. And if I was tuning this car with a big tire slick car, even though I'm under 100% anti-squat, I know that, especially with a single adjustable shock, it is still not going to have control of the rear end. It's going to hit the sidewall too hard and likely unload it. But let's take a look and see how this run does with this new setup. All right, so we got a little different angle. It actually looked like it was going to hold it, but check this out. It still separates the wheel into the sidewall of the slick really, really hard. It hits the sidewall so hard, it tries to bring the front end up, and it brings the front end up really quick, and then it unloads the rear end. So here again, this is on a track surface, not a street, and you can see how hard it hits the slick. The front end comes up so fast, it just unloads the rear. Now remember, on this car, this Barracuda does not have a lot of front end travel. Could we have slowed down the front end and helped with this? Probably. Could we have maxed out the rebound valving on this shock and maybe help control it better? Maybe. But now this is a very common problem on a lot of big tire slick cars that are trying to run more of the economy series, a double adjustable or single adjustable shocks. In this situation, if we were running some Penske 7500s with my valving in them, or had we been running AFCO big gun shocks made for big tire slicks, we could have probably made this car work at this current instance center. But it still isn't ideal considering the wheelbase and everything else of this car and the center of gravity. So let's go ahead and take a look at the third top position of the bar. Now we can see we are at 62.2 inches instant center length. All three runs are at the same instant center height because the bottom bar is parallel. So by changing the top bar angle, we're only changing the length of the instant center, not the height of the instant center. Now you can see we're at 71.1% anti-squat, and now check this out. The instant center is actually a little bit forward of the center of gravity. Now I can tell you from experience, and you're getting ready to see, this big tire slick car is going to be much happier with the more economy series shocks, especially the single adjustable shock that this car has on it. This is a very typical big tire instant center four link setup, but let's see how the video shows this. Now, Z was in the right lane for this, but you're still going to get a good side view, and you're going to see how much better the car operates with this scenario. So let's take a look at this one. There's room for improvement here, and Z understands that. He understands we probably want to slow the front end down a little bit. Watch and hear this full run of this car, and we're gonna have the audio on for this run so that you get to see the full run, and the camera actually comes around and it'll show you the quarter mile ET and the miles per hour. Let's check out the full run. Thank you. 860 at 156 miles an hour. And Z told me the car was around the 123 60 foot mark on a run like this. All of this by making one change at a time and bringing the upper bar up one hole at a time, going out and testing the car. And this car just ran 860s at 156 miles an hour with single adjustable strange engineering shocks. That is so cool. Hey, once again, a huge shout out to Z at ZHTunes. I really appreciate Z working with me on this video content. Please go out and support his social media. I'll have all of his links and stuff in the description of this video. But I just had to share this information with my subscribers because this just demonstrates how that upper bar angle really impacts the four-link on a big tire slick car, small tire slick car, and a radial car. There are some just basic principles around what's going on with the four-link bars, and this video, I felt, did a great job of laying that out for you. Just remember, we're trying to do three things. Just what Z accomplished. We want to go fast, we want to go straight, and we want to be safe. Have a good day, guys. Tu 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 tu.